Super Bowl didn't disappoint. I think it was one of the better Super Bowls that we've seen. In my opinion, it's probably top five, top seven Super Bowls that I've witnessed. Obviously it came right down to the very end. Chiefs pulled it out 25-22. I predicted, 27-24 Chiefs win. So I wasn't that far off. But first off, let's get your first thoughts on what happened, what took place.
Yeah, you nailed it. Fantastic game. One of the better ones I've ever seen. And I had it wrong. I had the little bang, bang, Niner gang winning that thing. And it wasn't, after the first quarter, it didn't look like a possibility. They right. didn't stick, in my opinion, with the game plan. But that's a Shanahan special, and I should have known that. So I think that, the air got tight, and he couldn't breathe there right after halftime. But
now,
I was surprised.
What it is, his butthole got tight. That's what happened. Butthole got tight and got away from the game plan. Pathetic. Pathetic.
And even though he was still up in the score, I think that, momentum is not a scoreboard thing. It's a feeling.
Thank you.
I think that feeling went away because they were dominating the first couple drives, one in and then a turnover. But when it was 125 yards for the Niners to 19 for the Chiefs or whatever it was domination. And I think everybody can coach from on top.
Yep.
Once that momentum swung and Patty Boom Batty got it figured out and got it cooking, his booty hole got tight and going away from that game plan, which I think should have been a best running back in the game this year and best offensive lineman in the game. Some people out there disagree. I think he went away from it.
He absolutely did. Here's my thing. It's a Super Bowl. What are you holding them for? What are you right. waiting for? Everybody says, well, he had 30 touches. McCaffrey, who we're talking about, by the way, had 30 yeah. touches in the game. Well, my whole thing with that is, well, it should have been 50 if right. you're trying to win the Super Bowl. What right. are you waiting for? They went away from him, Chris, basically from the end of the first quarter to about, the middle of the third quarter, closer to the end of the third quarter. Just keep running the football, right. man. What are you doing?
How many touches is too many for the most dangerous guy on the field?
Thank you. Not to mention, how many touches is too many when you're trying to win the last game of the season?
Right.
Use him Absolutely. Up. If he gets 50 touches, then he gets 50 touches. Right. If you win, who cares? Who right. cares? Nope.
No one remembers. Absolutely. But everybody's going to remember that you keep getting to the dance and not showing up, right?
And not only that, you keep getting to the dance. Keep getting a big lead, and you cannot hold it. I mean, how many times are we going to see that with this guy?
Yeah.
It's just over and over and over again. Now, look, I get the first time he wasn't the head coach, but he was right. damn sure the offensive coordinator responsible for calling plays in that debacle of Atlanta giving up a 28-3 lead. That was right. his fault. He could have right. run the ball the entire second half, three and outs, and they would have won the football game. He doesn't do it, and they get beat.
The very definition of booty holes getting tight was that game, right?
God. We should have known from the very beginning that's what this guy is. We should have known, Chris, that's what this guy is.
And let's talk about what things you prevent by running the ball, right? We all know that you put the ball in the hands of your best player on the field, the best offensive threat. But more importantly, you keep the ball away from Patty Mahomes. You start eating up that clock. Just like when that Atlanta game you're talking about. Why am I giving the ball back to the best guy on the field that much? And that was insane. That game lasted 20 minutes longer than it should have because I would have just – I could have taken a knee three times and punted and used up a lot more clock than that.
Oh, it's just absolutely incredible. Not to mention – now, look, I gave Brock Purdy all the credit. And Brock Purdy didn't play bad in the game. I actually thought he played good.
Yeah.
But third down, 3-for-12, Chris. You're 3-for-12 on third down.
What situation are you putting them in, right? Those weren't – all third downs are not created equal, right?
Okay. 3-for-12, I don't care what situation is it. That's not good.
I'm sorry.
We can't make excuses for it.
Even with a couple of bad results, McCaffrey was averaging 4 a pop. So, I'm sorry. 2nd and 6, 3rd and 2.
Yeah.
I bet Purdy was converting, but it wasn't 3rd and 2. It wasn't. So, I don't know how many of those he was put in the right situation for.
Well, I get it. I don't think Purdy – like I said, this is not Purdy's fault. I thought Purdy played fine. I thought he played fine. I don't think he made the plays to win.
Right.
But at the same time, the game plan kind of took that away.
He didn't make the plays to lose.
He didn't make the plays to lose either. No, he did not. He absolutely didn't.
Yeah,
I guess he didn't give the ball away.
You got Buddy in the comments saying the Niner players didn't know the overtime rules. I keep hearing everybody saying that like it matters. Like it doesn't matter. No, it didn't.
It kind of matters.
Since when would the rules have changed whether or not you want to stop somebody trying to score a touchdown?
But it matters because if they didn't know, then the coach damn sure didn't know. That's my point. If the players don't know, which means he didn't go over it with the players, now he's trying to come out. I saw this report earlier on ESPN. Oh, we went over it. So your players are lying? Which is it, Kyle? Just admit it. You didn't know, so your players didn't know. And so now, and that's what it came down to. He tried to come out and say, well, we had a plan of what we were trying to do. Really, that plan included taking the ball first and giving an opportunity to the best quarterback in the world four downs to beat you. That's what the plan was? Give me a break, man. I don't want to hear it.
That's unfortunate. We got some people saying devil's advocate, you know, Chiefs were expecting the run and stacking the box. You know, I'm going to say, yeah, they were, but the Niners knew that. We all knew that the Niners run game was going to be the key to the game. So that didn't change. Yes, I do think, you know, to April's point over there, the Achilles injury. I mean, that second, third best player on the Niner defense going down, running onto the field was crazy. But I don't like to play the if this guy plays and if he doesn't. There's some things that were completely in your control.
Well, the one thing that I know for a fact is that Dre Greenlaw going down absolutely hurt them. But that had zero to do with Kyle Shanahan running the football. Absolutely nothing. Had zero to do with it. Not to mention, he got hurt, I think, the second or third drive of the game. The 49ers hadn't scored a point yet. The score was still 0-0. So they still got up 10 points without him. So him getting hurt, it changed some of the stuff that they were trying to do. But the last time I checked, Pacheco didn't do anything on the ground. So they weren't. It's not like the Chiefs were just running the football all over the place. Heck, you could also say the left guard, Alec Grady, I think that's how you pronounce it for the Chiefs, he tore his UCL ligament in his elbow in the second quarter. So he's not even able to block people. He's out there playing with one arm. So you got me thinking.
You got me thinking about when maybe the booty holes tightened up. When did Debo go down with that injury?
Oh, I can't remember exactly when. But he wasn't hurt either because he came back and he was playing.
Yeah, but that changes the atmosphere. I mean, that may be the tipping point for a coach who's already, you know, the windpipe's getting tight, getting ready to choke, and then Debo goes down with what we thought was a hammy, right?
No.
And I don't remember what it was.
I mean, it was a hammy, but I just don't buy it. First of all, is a hammy that bad? I think a lot of people have had a hamstring injury. You ain't coming back.
No, but I'm saying,
if it's hurt, you're not coming back.
Did that change Mr. Shanahan's plans? And then he never could recover from that. We've all been shell-shocked.
I don't think so, because Debo had 10 targets in the game. So, it's not like he just didn't go back to him. He had 10 targets in the football game, including a deep shot. So it's not like he didn't try to give him the football. The Chiefs just said, no, you're not going to beat us with Debo Samuel. You're going to go with somebody else. And they were doing it. I mean, Jennings hadn't done a ton all year, and he was killing them.
They took Ayuk out of the game for the most part, too. So they did make him beat him with somebody that they didn't see coming, right?
And we can also stop the comparisons to George Kittle to Travis Kelce. George Kittle, 2 catches, 4 yards. Enough with the compare. He's a way better blocker, better blocker than Travis Kelce could ever dream about being. That goes without saying. But as far as just complete tight end or catching the pack, come on. 2 catches, 4 yards, don't want to hear it.
Right. You're not going to hear that from me. You're going to hear me say, I got it wrong. Not often you hear people just say, I got it wrong. The Chiefs are a better ball club than they showed most of the end of the year, into the postseason, and they got it done. So,
yeah, I get that. I understand. But the more important thing about this whole conversation
– tell me about it.
I was right and you were wrong. I think that is the most important. I think that's what people in the chat kind of want to talk about is how I was right. I picked the game correctly, like I usually do.
Sure.
And you picked the game wrong, like you usually do. I mean, I think that after saying all of that, it just comes down to Brian was right. Chris, he was wrong.
I'm a firm believer that everybody in the world is 50-50, right? So let's move to the next topic, and let's see if CeCe was correct on the second topic, you know? And maybe I'm going to make a comeback here, you know?